There is a battle going on when it comes to healing through prayer.
No fear.
Torben here is under fire in his own country. What he did for me, it was one big blessing. Although I lost my leg, I am so very, very, very much blessed.
In the name of Jesus, I commanded pain to go. All pain, come out. Last thing, go. Go, last thing, go. Come out. Go right now, last thing, come out. There's freedom, try to walk. How is it? How is it? Do you feel the pain? No fear. Look at me. No fear. Come. No pain. No fear, no pain. No pain. No pain. No pain. No fear.
Yeah. Strange. I haven't walked for a year, more or less.
Yeah. And used to it and.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, don't go too far because I need to go far.
Christ. Jesus Christ.
Die with Christ. Rise up.
No!
Hallelujah. Glory, thank you for a new life. The old thing is gone. Something new has started. All is died with Christ. It's rise up with Christ. All sin, all shame, all guilt, all wrong spirit is gone in the name of Jesus.
Yes!
Grote gaten in wordt het niet. En tot vorige week kon Tom echt letterlijk niet zijn tenen neerzetten of hij ging van de grond door de grond van de pijn. En de afgelopen 3 dagen is er een helingsproces ingezet. Met als resultaat dat vandaag de foto's lieten zien en dat zei de arts heel mooi: het ziet er heel netjes uit voor 6 weken. Dus eigenlijk is in 3 dagen tijd is het werk van 6 weken gedaan.
Ja, gedaan.
Kijk, ik noem dit een actieve voet. Zie je, hij is nog wat warm. Je ziet, hij is nog wat, hij verkleurt nog een beetje. Mm-hmm. Maar dat past dus bij een voet in reparatie. Hè? Dat is dus niet erg. Dat is prima. En de enkel is mooi. Kan ik hem nou zo vastpakken?
Ja hoor.
Dat is ook beter, hè?
Ja.
Want dat is normaal, is dat een probleem.
Zij ziet een normaal patroon. En wij weten hoe het vorige week nog was. Als we hier, zeg maar hetzelfde als vorige week dinsdag was, als het nu was geweest, hadden we nu over amputatie gepraat.
It's just about a full year ago that I was baptized here in the battle. I was suffering from arthritis. I was prayed for, I got healed, I got from my wheelchair, I walked around, I got baptized the same evening.
And the weeks came and went and you saw the healing process continuing. And of course his dream was to go back to work. And he did, started off real easily. But then he sprained his ankle and then he took a wrong step, and after that it looked like he was hurt too many times and all the progress was taken away from us. And in the end we ended up being worse than before, ever before.
There was some bone growth in my ankle, but it wasn't sufficient enough. There was more
deterioration.
You need to understand, because bone needs to have pressure. It needs to work to grow.
Yeah.
But when you twist your ankle, you don't want to use it. So in the end, I was in so much pain, I was not using my foot anymore. I couldn't stand it on it. That the deterioration of the bone was going faster than the new grown bone.
Yeah.
So yeah, it was one step forward, two steps back, if you know what I mean. And yeah, then all of a sudden I couldn't stand up anymore because the pain was too great.
So then there was no other option, humanly possible option left, but a below knee amputation?
Before the amputation, it was still like, I have a Bible app that I read, and all of a sudden someday I saw a quote and it says, it's better to be healthy in the mind than in the flesh. And that was for me the break point of, that's it.
Yeah.
It did nothing to my faith. Because of my faith, I am here now being happy, being a happy amputee. Because I am so glad that that leg is gone. Because nowadays I'm completely pain free.
I was really tested in my faith. Because here I was, my husband got out of the wheelchair, got back to work, so I didn't need to do it alone anymore. And all of a sudden he was back in the wheelchair and I was like, here we go again, how can this happen?
Yeah.
And it took a little time to adjust to the possibility for me that he was going to be amputated because I didn't know what we got into, what we were getting into, because I was very much afraid for phantom pain, for not healing properly or whatever, but in the end what we had was no option. So any option was better than that option. And let me tell you, the whole world prayed their hearts out and we were so much strengthened by that,
blessed.
And we were also tested by other people, like, wait, your God can do anything, everything and anything.
Why aren't you healed?
Why aren't you healed?
Completely.
Yeah, see, you're not healed, so your God is not a good God. And the more I heard that, it hurt, of course, but the more I heard that, the more I was like, wait a second, this is not God doing this.
You don't know my God.
This is God turning something really bad into something really good. It hurts, it really, really hurts. Not for him alone, but for me too, for our children, for everybody around us, standing there in prayer and seeing this happen. And we still don't understand it. But when his day came and when he had his surgery and when he came back, ever since, he has broken every single record in his rehabilitation.
The man next to me in hospital, he also had a below knee amputation. It was maybe 1, maybe 2 days before me.
Yeah.
And that man, he was a little bit older than I was, but he was so bitter. So very bitter. He was angry. He was cursing. He was swearing. And I was sitting upright and being cheerful. And come on, man, you can do it. He was like...
Yeah.
He was so harsh.
In his opinion, his life was over.
Yeah.
And mine
was starting again.
Our life was starting again. Yeah.
And it was yeah.
And that amputation day, that surgery day, I was so peaceful. I was like, he's in God's hands. What can happen? What can happen? He's in God's hands. So yeah, that we have the I would say the right. It sounds a bit bold, but when you get baptized and you repent and you turn to God and you follow in his footsteps, then somehow that gives you the right to his grace and his blessings. And if there's anything we have experienced this last year, above all, it's that. So we consider ourselves very, very extremely blessed. And even though we were like thrilled last year and never thought there would be anything else but a complete healing, physically. We still see this whole process as a healing of our, of both of us.
Yep.
So we are way better than we were. We are in a way better position than we were last year, even though he's been amputated. Yeah.